a Q&A on if you're interested in starting a cake business, or if you guys have questions about anything cake related, feel free to ask me. I'm gonna see if I can find the chat. I don't see it. I don't see a chat. Some message. So if somebody could just say something in the chat, I want to see if I can see it. That would be great. If for some reason I don't get the chat working, I will come back later and look. Oh, here we go. Oh, hi, Irene. Thank you. Hi, Molly. So I'm just going to get right into it. Hi, Teresa. I had some questions already from my community, so that really helped because I was able to kind of think about what I wanted to say. Mr. Blue, are you here? Mr. Blue had a question for me. Maybe I'll wait till he comes on. I know some of you already have cake businesses, Molly for one. Irene, I believe you have some kind of a cake business going. Teresa, you have your online food channel. And also, you had a bakery at one point, so that's pretty cool. I'd love to actually ask you some questions about that someday. Hi, Tammi. Tammy's here. So you guys, if you have any questions, go ahead and ask me. I already have some questions here to answer, and I'm going to go ahead and start answering those now. So, Mr. Blue asked me about when I started decorating, like how long have I been cake decorating? And I couldn't believe it when I thought about it. It's pretty much forever. It's 37 years, which is probably how old Mr. Blue is because he's my son's age. All right, I'm just gonna keep going here. So I keep looking at the chat and getting distracted. Okay, so you guys are all saying hi to each other, cool. All right, so I'm gonna talk about a little bit how I got started cake decorating. In 1984, my girlfriend Jane asked me to make her wedding cake. That's how I got into this whole thing. And when I found out I was gonna be making her wedding cake, I decided to take some classes. So that's how I started. And it was one of those Wilton cake classes at the local cake decorating shop. And it was basically like learning how to make a rose, learning how to do basket weave, how to make borders, that kind of a thing. And then my girlfriend, who lived in California at the time, and she still does, and I lived in Connecticut, her mom had all those really old Wilton books, the magazines with all the different ideas. And I looked in there and she let me choose whatever cake I wanted. And it was this like really kind of gaudy in a way, like cake with pillars and cupids and that kind of thing. So, and garlands and stuff like that. Excuse me. I gotta get some water. So that's how I got started. And after I made her wedding cake, which was in California, I met my husband, Scott, you guys know Scott, at her wedding. And we got married a year later and had our wedding. So that's how we got started. And then I moved to California. Hi, Karen. I moved to California and basically started looking for a job in a bakery so that I could learn a little bit more about how to decorate cakes. And there's Janelle. Hi, Janelle. So I started working in a bakery in California for probably a year. I worked there and I worked underneath a cake decorator. I was like the second cake decorator there, learning from his name was Lorenzo. When I look back at this, it was really interesting because the bakery was owned by a Japanese company and it was a French bakery. And there was an American woman who managed it, and my cake decorator teacher was Mexican, and all the guys in the kitchen were Japanese. So it was an interesting mix and interesting time. About a year into that, I got fired because a new company bought the bakery. And so that was my first experience getting fired. And then I decided, okay, I'm opening up my own thing. I'm just gonna bake cakes out of my house. So that's how I got started with baking cakes out of my home. And that brings me to a question. WNSABU is a follower here, and she asked me a question. She asked me quite an in-depth question, actually. She wants to know how to start a cake business, basically. The way I did it was I just started. I just got some cards and handed them out to everybody and kind of worked the streets and started making cakes out of my home. It wasn't a licensed bakery or anything like that. It was just, I just threw this thing together. And I did that for probably a couple years in California. My husband would come, Scott would come with me, and we would, you know, bring the, deliver the wedding cakes. And that was really fun. Then we moved back to Connecticut. And I had to start over in Connecticut, although I'm from Connecticut, so I did have a lot of connections. And I started working in another bakery. So this particular bakery was more like a coffee house with a bakery. They did baked goods. And I got to work at night with a girlfriend who made the bread. I made the cookies, cakes, and all that stuff. And that was a blast. That was really fun. So that was for a little while I got on my feet and started my own business again. This time was a bigger deal. So as far as starting a cake business, the way I did it was I just did it. I did not get licensed. I'm not saying that you should do that. I'm saying that that's the way I did it. And it worked out okay for me because I got really involved and I was making a lot of wedding cakes for the local people, like the local wedding cake places, the venues. And I was very, very busy. And the neighbor reported me because of the traffic. She didn't like the fact that there was people coming in and out. And I understand. So she called the town hall. The town hall, the inspector came out and inspected my facility, my kitchen, and gave me the go-ahead. So it was serendipitous because I was able to do this legally, so I didn't have to like hide it, and it worked out really well. I'm not suggesting you do that. I think the first thing you should do when you're thinking of opening a cake business is to call your town hall, start asking questions, find out what the legalities are and all that stuff. That would be the wise thing to do. You know, make sure that you're covered with insurance and all that stuff. So that's how I did it, and it worked out okay for me. And many, many years of that was what I did. And then I did go in and out of cakes, so it wasn't like constant. So I did other things, and then I came back to the cakes. I always come back to the cakes. And that's what happened 10 years ago when I came back to cakes again online, because I had an injury. So my neck, my disc in my neck twice went out, and it was really, really horrible and painful. And it was a year each time of getting better. So I stopped making the cakes for a while and I went online. And when I went online, I started my wedding cake online business, which is what I'm doing now still, 10 years later. So Karen says they have cottage laws. I can't read that whole thing, it's fading here. Let me see if I can go back to that. So I knew that I would get some really great information from other cake decorators and people like Karen. And so hopefully WNSABU, I don't think you can even pronounce that, will come on and see what you guys are offering as well. So thank you for that. And Molly, bodybuilding discs going out. I was a bodybuilder, yeah, for a while, and it wasn't the bodybuilding really. I don't think that did it. I know what it was. It was way, way back. I got into a car accident when I was like 15, and everybody else got like, you know, bloody messes, and I got the whiplash. So I didn't really realize I got injured. And then years later, 15 years later, actually, I realized I had whiplash. So that's what it was. And I still suffer to this day. And it's just awful. But I'm always working to try to, you know, offset that. So that's my physical issue that I have to deal with on a daily basis. But I'm trying to stay positive. And I do also dance, as some of you know. Let's see. So she wanted to know what equipment and all that stuff. So what I did and what I would highly recommend if you're going to start a cake business is, and tell me if you guys have done this, you can find a lot of used equipment out there because a lot of people start businesses and then they fail, unfortunately. But that's how I got my equipment, and I got a lot of equipment. I got a Blodgett oven convection, a big mixer. I still have the mixer down in the basement. I bought a couple of used fridges and she had a couple of racks, cooling racks. Even the rack that goes on the ceiling with all the stuff hanging on it, I had that in my kitchen. And all of that, I believe I paid like $1,500, which is really, really cheap. And there's Ebony. Hi, Ebony. I couldn't read that whole thing. I'll come back to the chat later. So I'm gonna just tell WNSABU, I don't know how to say it. If she wants, or if any of you guys want to, you can go to my website. I left a link below and you can get this. It's 7 questions you absolutely need to have answered before starting a cake business. So I have this, it's a PDF, it's at the website. You guys can go ahead and download that. Usually that's just for my cake book customers, but go ahead and do that just for you guys today. So let me go to the next question, because this has everything that I was gonna talk about here, but you can just go ahead and get that. Irene says hi to Ebony. So Tech Tales asked a question about freezing cakes. She said, how do you freeze cakes without them getting water droplets? I've never had that problem. So when the cakes are frozen and sometimes there's some steam in there and it does form like a ice crystals, what I do is I take the cake out of the freezer and I just kind of wipe all that off so that the water droplets don't form. And Tammi has some advice as well. So, because Tammi just recently started, went through all this. So that's great, Tammi, thank you. And then also, when you're freezing your cakes, Tech Tales, when you're freezing your cakes, you wanna, I like to let them cool off almost completely, and then I cover them and leave a little hole in the top so that steam escapes. Then I put them in the freezer after they're completely cool. That way there's not as much water droplets. However, I have heard other cake decorators wrap them up hot and then put them in the freezer. So I don't know. I don't really feel comfortable doing that. And then she wanted to know, how do I figure out buttercream amounts? So when you do this a lot, you get really good at just like estimating. So I just kind of like think about the wedding cake and I'm like, okay, 14, 10, 6, I need about 4 to 5 batches. But I also took the time a while back to do some cake costing. So I did track for a while just to kind of see what I was using. So I have a sheet here and I put down all the different amounts of the batter, how much buttercream, the size of the cake, et cetera, et cetera. This whole thing, cake costing, pricing wedding cakes, et cetera, is in my guide, which is at the website. The same page where this is, if you guys wanna check it out, the trailer is there, so you can look at the trailer. But in 2 weeks, I'm gonna be doing a launch. And I'm gonna be launching the wedding cake guide and the buttercream guide, which is at that page. So there's gonna be a special deal. So you might wanna wait, if you do decide you wanna get something, wait till the 21st for your special price. All right, so the other questions. She wanted to know how I can make a cake without using a recipe, but that, I think she's confused because I do use recipes. I've been using recipes all along, I might tweak a recipe to fit my needs, but most of the recipes I use are from like literally when I first started, because I found recipes that I love and I just stick with them. However, since then I have experimented with different recipes, and they're on the YouTube channel that I also really love. Sunflower. Okay, so we have a couple requests here. One is from Sunflower, and she wanted to know if I do a video of Chantilly frosting. I have not made that yet, but it sounds delicious, and I love mascarpone cheese, and it's got cream cheese and whipped cream and butter. I don't know if you guys have tried that yet, but it sounds amazing. So I am going to do a video on that. And I got a request from Jan Fleetwood, who wants a video of the royal icing flowers on the toothpicks. So I do have a video on that, but I'm going to do a specific video with just the rose on the toothpick. That will be coming up. And let me see if I can see the chat. Nope. Sorry. I just turned it around. Okay, that was my office. Does anyone know how to get to the chat? I guess on the phone, it's kind of like it pops up and then it goes away. So actually, I'm going to take this over to my computer because I can see the chat over there. So hang in there, guys. The lighting's not as good, but just want to see if I missed anything here. Wow, lots of stuff in the chat. Yes, so Tammi wants to know if she can give some advice, and yes, feel free. And then Karen says, it's $400 permit to bake out of your home. Wow, that's awesome. It's definitely worth $400. If you're serious about building a home-based company, you need to figure out a name. Yep. And go online to the Department of Revenue and make sure that your name is available. That's a good point. Diana Ninu says, lucky to get all equipments with those prices. Yeah, I was really, really lucky. It was a woman who was doing brownies out of her home, and she was willing to just get rid of it for a really cheap price. And then I'm still using whatever I have since the business had taken minimum to my capacity. Yeah, so that's another point I wanted to make, was that you don't really need a lot of a fancy equipment. I mean, I use my oven, my normal oven now. It's a convection, but it's just a normal size. I can do a full-size wedding cake, 14, 10, 6. That's like the bigs I go. You can use your regular KitchenAid mixer. You don't need the big mixer. You can do lots of batches. It's nice to have the big mixer, you know, when you get into doing a lot of wedding cakes, but an extra fridge always helps. I have one in my basement. You don't have to spend a lot of money to get started, really. Then file for your EIN number and then check your state, Tammi says, and your local health department to find out if you have a cottage law. And if you plan on selling things like Italian buttercream, you can get an annual license, and that will cover you to make and sell pretty much anything. Thank you, Tammi. That was great information. There should be a note icon. Okay. All right. Thanks, Diane. I'm actually at my computer, then I can see it better. There should be, yes, two refrigerators as for sure are small, or a small chest deep freezer is a must. The more freezer space, the better, as you know, because you can freeze your cakes. That makes everything so much easier. And that's it for the chat. There might be something at the top that I missed. All right, so I think I'm going to, if you guys don't have any more questions, I'm probably going to end it, because I try to keep these to like 20 minutes, and I can't believe it's already been 18 minutes. 19 people watching, 18 minutes. Okay, cool. Jean P is here. Hey, hi Jean. So as far as advertising goes, word of mouth is the best. And I recommend getting some cards, just some simple business cards, and maybe even making some samples and going around to all the local, like people that are involved in weddings, like photographers, florists, let's see, what else? Go to the venues themselves and, you know, do that. Get people to taste your cakes. That's a really, really good way to do it. Also try to, something that I did when I first started was I had my mom call actually the newspaper and say, oh my gosh, did you hear about this new cake decorator in town? And they came and did a story on me. So that really helped a lot. And then a couple times the newspaper did come out and do stories on me, which was, I still have those articles and they're at the website as well. Sam's Club or a Costco, that helps. They sell the best refrigerators. Great tip, Tammi. Tammi paid $224 for her refrigerator and a deep freezer. So I'm glad that you came, Jean. Jean and I were just talking on Facebook, actually, and she was kind of wondering about how to advertise her cakes. I'll give it a few more minutes if you guys have any more comments. And also you can leave comments below in the underneath afterwards if you guys think of anything. And Ebony, did you make any items and drop them off at businesses? This is before becoming licensed. Yes. I mean, yes, I did. I actually worked for, it was a lot looser back then. This is a long time ago. It wasn't quite as stringent as today's laws. And I also worked through one of the venues, so I had them as a backup. In other words, I could use their kitchen if I needed to. So I was delivering wedding cakes and to a venue in town. Yes. And then I ended up working for those venues later, so I stopped doing my business and I was working for them in their kitchen. And they had three venues at the time, so I was doing all their wedding cakes, pastries, etc. It was a lot of work, and I ended up hurting myself, so my neck became an issue with that. I couldn't do it anymore. I had to stop. So that's why I do it out of my home now in a small way, and I just literally take one wedding cake per weekend. I try to not take any more than that, and I'm slowly kind of making my way out of actually making the cakes and just teaching online and, you know, selling products online so that I can not do that anymore, because I'm not getting any younger and I think I've had a good run and I would like to just teach. Bridal shops, good. Bridal shops are great. Diana says, I did give away cake slices on some occasions when introducing my cakes and it works. Like little investment to gain more afterwards. Yeah, that's true. That's a small investment. Definitely have to get people to taste and tell them that you make them from scratch, because there are people that sell cakes that don't make them from scratch. And that's fine too. I'm not gonna put that down, because some of those box cakes taste pretty good. But I prefer to do homemade. Super smart working in a licensed kitchen. Thank you. Yeah, so of course, that's a much smarter for sure. And my kitchen was actually accepted through the town, so it, in a sense, was licensed. And they came in every 6 months, by the way, and checked. And they were pretty strict. What would you share for samples? Cupcakes to resorts and venues. What would you share? I would do resorts, wedding cake venues. Resorts is a good idea. Cupcakes is a nice way. They're smaller, but for me, cupcakes are, I would want to fill them with a filling, so it's not like just all cake with frosting on top. So that would be a thought. You can make a big sheet, fill it up, and slice it in little pieces. Teresa from Flour, Eggs, and Yeast says, I'm working, so can't really participate. That's okay, but I'm playing in the background, so it helps your views. Oh, thank you, Terry. Yeah, it's good to get views. All right, so any other questions? I see my fish in the background. So let me just get my notes. I want to make sure I didn't forget anything. I actually have, if you want to see real quick, I have a picture of my kitchen. I think it's in here. Yeah, I don't know if you can see this. but that was my kitchen. And I think I have it at the website as well. So you can see the mixer and the oven in the background. But I think I have a nice big picture of that at the website. So Tammi says, hey, one very important tip, y'all. If you sell to the public, you need to have stickers printed with ingredients. Good point. And if you use any peanuts, eggs, or milk, etc. Yeah, excellent point, Tammi. Do you put your hair in a net? I do, and I hate wearing it. I wear, when I bake, I either like really put my hair back tight and I put a band here, or I put my cap. I have like a baking cap. Sometimes I even wear my Red Chef hat, the one that I have in my photos. It looks really silly, but I wear it because I do not want my hair in the cakes. And when you have hair like this, it falls out and gets in everything. All right, and then my cats, they have to get locked upstairs. But yeah, that's an important point. And honestly, working out of my own kitchen, not to put down, you know, the commercial places, but a lot goes on in those kitchens sometimes. Not where I worked, it was very clean, but it's hard, you know, because there's a lot of people in the kitchen, there's a lot going on. To keep it clean is not easy. So I felt very, very good about my own situation in my kitchen, and I still do. Thank you, Tammi. I agree with you, it's very important, yes. All ingredients are just ingredients some may be allergic to. I believe all the ingredients have to be listed. Correct, Tammi? I don't sell stuff, packaged stuff like that, so I don't really know. But Tammi does. So once again, just a reminder, if you want to go to the website and get this, it's just basically a pamphlet, but it's got a lot of good information in it. You can print this out. I'm only going to leave it up for a couple of days because it's really for my customers, but I'm leaving it up for you guys if you want to go get it. It's probably like 10 pages and a little bit on marketing, etc., etc., and a little bit of online stuff and what equipment you need, etc. So Molly Cake says, and if toothpicks or support in cakes, people need to know. And yeah, if you put like little, if you put supports in your cakes or sticks, you definitely need to let the people know ahead of time. Yeah. Ebony, do you have a business, a cake business? There's a bit of a delay, so I'm kind of waiting. Not licensed yet, okay. Where do you live? Not all ingredients, only if you have a customer with allergies, you must put that on your package to cover your butt. Tammi, I love you. get her done, Tammi. Ebony says, gotcha. Okay. Ebony, where are you from? I'm in Connecticut. All right. So also, just while I have you guys on here, I know some of you already are in my classes, but I do have classes on Zoom. So you could also go to my website and check that out. I have a classes page. Oh, Virginia Beach. Wow, I love Virginia. Virginia is gorgeous. Butts always need to be covered, says Molly. Yep, Scott likes to do that with the subscribe pillow. Diane says, appreciate all inputs and answers to all questions. Really informative and gain new knowledge. Yay. Awesome, Diana. And Tammi said, not too bad for just a hillbilly. Oh, wow, I love it. Diane says, thank you. Thank you. Thank you, everybody, for coming. And I'm going to just, very nice, but this pollen is horrible. Oh, yeah, the pollen. Yeah, same here. All right, guys, I'm going to say goodbye. And thank you so much for coming. I appreciate it very much. And share this with your cake friends. Thank you. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Irene says, thank you. And Molly, thanks. Nice seeing my friends here. Thanks, Molly. All right. Thank you. Thank you, Ebony. Thank you, Teresa. And I'll see you guys here and there and everywhere. Okay, bye-bye.